one.
Alright, what if I told you that there was a phrase used way back in the day that was used the same meaning as karma, which we commonly use today? Back in the day, they used to say chickens come home to roost, which means the exact same thing as karma. And when you think of karma, you probably think of, like, people who do bad things to other people, and then, like, that bad thing will come back to them and haunt them or whatever. Phrases and sayings, like, some of them have to be deeper than the obvious. And years ago, like, a lot of people used, like, more, like, complex phrases. So, like, those obviously have to be thought deeper than the obvious. And they're not always going to jump right out at you and give you the meaning right away. To give you the real meaning of chickens come home to roost, I'll go over the origin, the deeper meaning, and why it was stopped being used over the years and turned into karma. In 1390, it was originally said as curses are like young chicken, they come home to roost. And then over the years, it just kind of evolved into chickens come home to roost, and that was in the 19th century. And why chickens is because chickens, when they're on a farm, they like are outside all day, and then they come back to their home at night, like to protect themselves from like all the other animals. So like they always come back to their house. Just like karma will always come back. This phrase, you have to think deeper because you wouldn't really know it off the top of your head. And like it has to be thought deeper than the obvious to like actually understand it. Like it doesn't make sense at first, but then once you start thinking of it, it makes sense. It's evolved over the years because first it was curses are like young chicken, they come home to roost, and then it was chickens come home to roost, and then it changed to home to roost, and then finally it just became karma. And phrases have to be thought deeper than the